What's going on, YouTube? It's Grifzy coming with some Madden 20. We about to start this character. We're going to try to make him realistic. You know, we're going to try to go off my personal build, my own build. So it's going to be a realistic Grifzy motherfucking quarterback. He got to be 6'7", a young nigga 6'7" right now. So you know what he got to be. So let's do it.
I want you to be our starting quarterback. And I'm talking from day one. If you work hard, you focus, and you commit, you're not only going to graduate here with a four-year degree, we're going to win a national championship together.
A fucking degree? No. Fucking 3 weeks to signing day, I mean. I've seen you. Make sure everything cool. They be like to like throw a little shit in and shit.
I want to take a moment to thank all the coaches who helped me along the way.
I want to thank everyone for showing up today.
Look, guys, I just want to thank my teammates, especially my O-line.
What the fuck?
Hey, don't forget to thank your mom. Never forget to thank your mom.
I didn't choose that one.
Mind telling me where you're going to be signing?
Actually, it's why I'm hiding in here.
I did.
Well, I know you'll make the right choice. And if you need any advice, I'm always here.
Okay, cool. Thanks, man.
Yeah, anytime. Actually, I've been meaning to run into you. Hello? Hello?
It gonna be
okay. OSU, you already know. What? Y'all got me fucked up. What's the closest? Man. I'm going to Miami. The fuck is y'all talking about?
Sure, the new kid could do any of these things. Don't you think that's a little harsh, Nate? 4 years ago, he was a five-star recruit. They had high hopes for this dude.
Doesn't that say something right there? What happened to that trust?
Coach, you wanted to see me.
Come in. I want you to be the first to know that Marcus Washington decommitted last night. And he's coming here.
What? That doesn't make any sense. You said I was going to be the starter.
He's the number one recruit in the country, son. And there's no guarantees in college football. I'm sorry.
I'm not going anywhere. Bring him in. I'll win the job. Just wait.
If you're the coach, how do you let five-star talent waste away on the bench for this long?
Better question is, if you're a young five-star recruit, why do you stay with a coach that doesn't play?
Because he's got something to prove.
To who? To that coaching staff, man. I mean, the same group of guys who spent the last 4 years telling him you're not good enough. He's got to prove it to those guys.
Yeah, take this.
Bitch ass, fuck it. I ain't gonna talk about it.
All right, gentlemen. Like Coach and I always say, second you step off this bus, you're on a business trip. We got a lot of work to do, so let's get to it.
You're the guy to get it done.
One in there. This is for players and coaches only.
Who we about to play? Oh, Florida versus Florida State.
I'm here to play Florida State.
What?
The Seminoles, yeah.
You?
Okay. What's your name?
That's me.
That's you?
Yeah.
Well, I know who you are, but go ahead.
I'm the quarterback.
What?
Yeah.
Excuse me. You're the quarterback, right?
Yeah.
Don't look so surprised. It's my job to know the roster. I'm Taylor Bennett. I'm working the sidelines tonight.
Okay, cool. Nice to meet you.
Do you mind if I ask you a few questions?
Okay,
I'm just going to record them.
Are we all the same height?
So, we all know your situation tonight, but we really don't know much about you as a quarterback. How would you describe your style?
Might be a couple episodes of this shit. Strong arm, improviser.
Well,
strong arm.
Oh, man. Hey, what's up, man? Well, I've always had a big arm, so just throw it deep, let my receivers get under it.
Okay. Now, how about your personality? Or better yet, how would your teammates describe you?
I'm crazy.
How would my teammates describe
me? Yeah, intense. Were you intense? You were cutthroat, a great leader, a jokester? Give me something.
You know, back in high school, guys did kind of find me pretty intense.
Intense, okay.
Yo, Taylor. Hey, can I borrow him for a second?
Oh, yeah.
Wait, hold up. You're a Heisman voter, right? Hey, I'm coming for that award next year. Look out for me.
Oh, I will.
Okay. All right, listen. You ready, right?
Yeah, man.
Yeah? Because winning the national championship means everything to me. All right, I made a promise to my brother. And since I can't throw the ball to myself, we need to be on the same page, you feel me?
I got you, man.
I ain't passing you shit. So it's always gonna be some sympathetic shit. Like, we here to play football, bro. I'm not here to pass you the ball. If you open, I will, nigga.
What do you think?
Well, his thinking is we keep it simple, you don't get overwhelmed, and then we rely on the defense to do their part.
Hey, hold on. This is a joke?
All right, look, coach just wants to put him in the best position to succeed.
No, this ain't high school ball, man. All right, this is the semifinals. If we go out there and simplify, they're going to destroy us. Right? Right?
Agreed. Coach needs to wake up. I'm ready for this.
Man, forget about him, man.
Listen, I don't care how much you played. You're a leader on this team. Leaders, sometimes they have to do what's right, even if they don't like it.
Got it, coach. I got you.
Yeah?
Do what's right, huh? Y'all not playing for no fucking scholarships. Y'all just trying to get some fucking money. It's okay.
As we'll see, the Florida State Seminoles taking on their in-state rivals to the south, the Miami Hurricanes.
What's up, bro? Good luck tonight.
Thanks.
Hey, man, don't listen to the critics. You got all the talent in the world. Just go out there and put on a show.
Thanks. Means a lot.
All right, man. Hit me up when you get to the league.
Yeah.
I'm talking to you all right, bro. 53 is the mark. Here we go.
But yeah. They'll go play action and let him throw right away. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that's
Let's go.
Inside the 35. Yeah, he will take this in for a Miami touchdown.
Control, that's first fucking play.
An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt.
Same shit. Right.
Here we go. 90 Wolf. 53.
On second down now. It's Larson. Still going. And just not a ton of
wrap up. And then the big finish with the tackle.
He'll look to throw.
Hey.
Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. It is starting to get really, really loud in here as this offense is on the move here in the first quarter. He's got the first down and more inside the
Get off me. He out.
And he will take this in for a Miami. so much of this offense the last few years centering around the combination of Marcus Washington and Isaiah Streets. Streets saying Washington's like a second brother to
really a gut-wrenching story, as you know. And you look back at their high school days right here in Texas, just outside of Houston. Zeke actually recruited by both of these teams playing here tonight.
And the two had dreams of playing for a national championship together. And now Isaiah with a chance to fulfill
it out there right now. But what I really liked, the way he's controlled this huddle, playing with a lot of confidence, and that confidence has been transmitted to the rest of the team.
General West, ready?
They'll look to throw now on first down.
Hey,
that is caught.
That could fuck him up real bad.
A good throw there, but boy, a tough situation for this offense. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. A 7-yard touchdown. The Hurricanes offense set to begin their next drive. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it could be much better than that. They've got to feel very good.
If there's some type of lingering animosity between quarterback and coach, because there certainly have been a few of those 56-7 type games over the last few years, but much like the Patriots.
Hey, I came back and got that dude.
Them out. So two thoughts come to mind. One, get some oxygen to fill up your lungs.
And he's going to score. Touchdown, Hurricanes. They had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time, they get at least a little bit more of a cushion in the field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot at how he wants to continue to throw the ball.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side.
That tight end is
brought down, but able to get tougher from here.
I'd have to agree with that because now there's going to be film and they'll game plan for him. But you look at our quarterback, he's had everything go his way so far. And as you just stated, no guarantees this continues on January the 7th. So we'll pump the brakes a little bit, but let's give credit where credit's due. In this ball game, he's been magnificent. But I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games,
to
throw. High point, boy, let's go.
Touchdown, Miami. Rifle this one deep right side. It got his man complete. It's a big play there on third down. Complete. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and ten. It actually gives him a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up.
The fact that we've got a quarterback who's never seen the field in a college football game, but you go back to his high school days, he's played in front of crowds. Maybe not quite this size, but it wasn't abnormal for them to have 15, 20,000 people in the stands at his high school. So it's not as if this guy doesn't know what he's doing out there under center. The Hurricanes now with a first and goal. And he will take this in. Touchdown, Miami. Keith Larson, as the first half is winding down. Three. They'll drop the throw. From the left side, complete. That's Simmons. And he's going to score. Touchdowns now with a first and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he will take this in. Touchdown, Miami. Stephon Stallings taking it. Next possession. And Charles, in a very one-sided affair, I think we reached the point in the broadcast for United. We may have some filling to do, right?
Yeah.
Down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. And he will take this in. Touchdown, Miami. Keith Larson taking it in. They have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum.
It's caught inside the 25. And he will take this in for a Miami.
Should we try it again?
Here's the Miami offense ready to go for their next possession. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point.
He got it again!
Inside the
20. He got it again!
Yeah, he will take this in for all but over. He's complete. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Looking to throw. He'll let this go for the end zone.
Let's go!
This is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out.
What?
So retract the yardage and retract the touchdown.
And retract the chunk play. Big strike there to get the touchdown. Now they've got to take it back and see if they've got another one still in their arsenal.
Now a second down throw for...
Yeah, baby, we going to the chip.
One more game, baby.
We got this, man.
Oh, yeah. Football is my life, man. But you got to stay grounded in what's important. So I got a little surprise for you.
Isaiah!
Em, looking good, Emily? Oh, and I'm loving this hat.
Thank you.
Oh.
Absolutely. Is that magenta? Fuchsia? What color is that?
Okay. Hey, I bet he'd probably be good at off the board, huh?
Yeah.
Look, Emily has the best games.
Okay. If you had a unicorn, would you want its mane to be purple or pink?
What's that well, shit? Purple. Like that kush.
Well, these are both tough, but good options. I think I'm gonna have to go with purple.
Purple. What? No, look. You see, look, you don't pick from the options given. All right, the game is in the name. Off the board. Now it's clicking. Okay, look, if I had a unicorn, I'd have a mane that matches his horn. Silver.
I'd go with onyx.
Onyx? Okay. I told you, she's a pro.
Hey, how are you? Todd Atwood. I'm Emily's dad.
Hi.
Can I talk to you for a second? She's too shy to ask, but Emily wanted to know if you could do something for her in the national championship game.
Yeah, of course. Anything.
What?
She wanted you to throw 3 touchdowns.
3? I thought I said 4.
I'll give you 7, little girl.
4 touchdowns.
Oh.
Is that okay?
Well, 4 touchdowns is a lot.
Yeah, but how can you turn down this face? Look at that.
But I'll see what I can do.
Yes.
Don't worry. You'll do it.
Thank you. Thank you very much.